As the old kid Ocean would say, that's all right with me. That's all right. For the day shall come, Yisraya, in the midst of Yah's great Beit, his house, which is great, whereby he has sealed the power of that with his identity, his name, whereby Yisraya shall gather, and there will be no need for preaching and teaching, for we all shall know as we are led by the Ruach HaKodesh, the power of his living Torah. We shall know all things as should be. And then only when we gather in the land of promise, under from under the shibboleth, the captivity, not only of our physical being, but of all our mental aspect, then we shall truly dance and sing and shout in the Beit of Almighty Yah, through the power and the revelation of Yahshua HaMashiach, for that is vitally important. There are all kinds of schisms and gods, and not one god is worth a damn. You know my vernacular and how I speak. There is not one god that's worth a damn brown penny. I don't apologize. I'm unapologetic when it comes to that, for he is the great one. And there is none other like him. We do want to greet you all, our friends, you that have joined us, and especially you, my enemies, because we feed you as well. Yah says, if your enemy is hungry, your oyeb, one that is diametrically opposed to you, then you feed them. So we bring to you today the meat of the living truth, the power of his testimony in Yahshua HaMashiach. And of course, we are not afraid to battle. We don't mind fighting. I'm a warrior. And a warrior has a cause that is greater than any inspiration, aspiration, desires, and passion. For the inspiration of Almighty Yahweh supersedes all of his ideas, his desires, his passions. He has one passion, because he will meet the ultimate warrior in the end. It's almost like a child that desires and wishes to meet what they call a superstar. My desire is to see him face to face, the power of this testimony, and see if it's real, for I know that it is real. Testimony of Yahshua HaMashiach is real. Again, greeting to our family of Yisraya. I do want to greet you all for your kindness, your support. Our Ochotz Blackman there in New Jersey, your kind, generous support is beyond expressive superlatives. So we do berach you for all your kindness. Our Ach Tezna and family there in Riverview, Tampa, Florida. The blessings of Yah rest upon you all. His berechaya, the riches of his great shalom, fill your home, for the great and kind support. Our Ach Yaakov there in Dallas, Texas, and also Ach Yaakov there in Jacksonville, Florida. We greet you all, our precious Ochotz Mariana there in Indiana. We toda you for all of your great support, Ima Oprah, and also our Ochot Rithiya, we greet you all in Yahshua's name. I know if I omit you, I am not trying to omit you by not calling your name, but we appreciate you all. I simply wanted to greet you all, our Ak, our Yaakob, our Ak, Charles Davis, with the gathering there in Los Angeles, California. Los Angeles, when I come, I'm coming to tear the devil's hell house down. I'm not coming to shop or to see the stars. Damn every one of the stars. Damn their walk of fame. It's not worth a damn penny. Do you understand? Yah's going to bring it down to the desolations of hell. So I'm not coming to see the false titties and the buttocks that are pumped up by silicone, I'm coming to knock the devil's house down. So we greet you all, our Jacques Tayon here there in Memphis, Tennessee, Ak William, his family, Akot Tiffany, and all 12 of you all there in Tennessee. That's a big house. Also, my precious Ak Frank and his wife, Diane, there in Nebo, West Virginia. We did hear from someone from Nebo, West Virginia. Who ever heard of Nebo, West Virginia? I have never heard of it until they began to contact us. So we did receive an email from one in the same city. We will be surprised as we think that there is no one in our vicinity that knows the R. It is false. There is a scattered remnant, a bore here, a people that has been elected by the wisdom of Almighty Yah. They are not convoluted. They have not been polluted by the religiosity and the religious practice. They have come out of this religious whoredom. They have cleansed their vessels, that their vessels or their clothing, their keli, is unspotted. So it is vitally important to us, Yisrael, that we cleanse ourselves from this corrupt world, that we do not be a partaker of her plagues and that which shall come. For it's one thing that is prominent in every man's life and every person, the one that's sitting beside you, one of you all will leave here first. You're going to die. And that's a fact. I don't give a damn how young you are or how old. You thinking that you have longevity, you're wrong. You're going to die. And that's a fact. And if I spend the rest of my few years on the earth seeking out the true dynamics of the promises of Yah, I will die that way. For what things garner or grant any kind of rewards? Tell me, your bank account can be laced with millions, but once life ceases, it produces nothing at all. And the wicked shall rage and take advantage of that. And you will see that your labor has been shalva. It was vain. It was empty. It did not produce anything at all. And so all that we do, Yisrael, despite what we call afflictions, these are light afflictions. Compared to the honor and the gadol, the great splendor of Yah, that shall be revealed at the coming of Yahshua HaMashiach. That's why the more of them are so vitally important, that we prepare our minds, our consciousness, that we are cognizant to the fact that Yah has spoken unto us, and there is nothing in the Torah nullified. Yah knew that we would be scattered throughout the breadth of the earth. He knew that we would be separated from the river Niles and the Euphrates, the great rivers, and we would be scattered to the four corners of the earth. He knew what would become of the tragedy of Yerushalayim because of the sins and the wickedness of a nation that he had elected. He knew that the bed would be destroyed and brought down to desolate. He knew that. And the only place that the pure offering or the Zabak, the offerings unto Yah, could be offered was in Yerushalayim. And he knew that. And so in his dispersing of his nation, his people, even before there was a concept of a thought, he knew that that would rise from the depths of his bosom, this living power, this Torah, that in the power of Yahshua HaMashiach and that name, that we can do all things according to what? According to his Torah. We can. He knew that in our privileged state that we could not traverse the ocean into the land we call Yerushalayim. But he knew that in that mind of Yahshua, that we can offer every zebach, every sacrifice, every offering, everything he command. Because if he spoke something to be nullified, then his word is not worth a damn. Every word of Yah is tahor. It is clean. It is absent from any kind of taintedness. It is pure. It is relevant. So what he spoke in Bereshit, it is relevant now. What he spoke in Devarim, it is relevant now. What he spoke in Weyira, it is relevant now. What he spoke in Bimetzbah and the book of Numbers, all of that is relevant. We have the living power now in Yeshua through the Ruach, not some damn Holy Ghost. Damn the Holy Ghost. It's not worth a damn dime. And that's a fact. Damn the Holy Ghost. It's a damn lie. It is a forest. It is a made up damn lie. It is his Ruach. Can I say this? I was talking to Zachain Davis. He said, I can't wait till you finish the booklet you're writing on the Sanskrit language. We are such a gullible people, Yisrael, that many of the translations, not transliteral, it came out of a language we call Sanskrit. Sanskrit. When you are defining words, its etymology, out of Webster, whether it is Webster, whether it is some of the most renowned dictionaries, you will find that there is an etymology or an origin of the word and where it derived from. And so the men that were translators of the Torah of the Hebraic language, the only language that was geared to what we call the religious deities, it was out of the root of the Sanskrit language, the Sanskrit. It is one of the 17 languages of the land we call India. It is a language, it is a tongue that is specifically to one aspect of the lives of the people of India, and that is to describe the Brahmas, the gods of Hinduism. That's what it's about. And so when you find the word holy, you will find its roots are not in the Hebraic, in something that is set apart, that is Kodesh or Kadosh. It is a word that derived to express the excellence or the spirit of the gods of the Brahmas, which constitute about 320 million gods. You understand? So it has no relevance. It has no fruitfulness when it comes to expressing Yah. So those men, the only way they could express the power of his Ruach, Yah is Ruach. He is not just a Ruach. He is Ruach. He is the life-bearing substance of all things. There is no life without Yah. There is no substance of life. So what they did in this combining of words, they retracted out of the Sanskrit language the word holy and the word ghost. Tell me what one that is not afraid of a ghost in the young bearing in the years. And so we as a people, we have been manipulated. Our minds have been manipulated. And don't tell me words have no significance and value, because they do. And so I am not afraid of saying, damn the Holy Ghost, but I would never attribute that to Yah, because Yah is Ruach. He is Ruach. It is Yah. It is his living power of his breath that dwells in us. That witness of his Torah, what he has written, he has inscribed indelibly. He has ingrained that in the mind, the bosom, the inward parts of his nation, Yisrael, a people that he has elected. And so the dismantling that through the process of this religious harlotry that everybody feels nice. Everybody's in every kind of practitioner, or they become practitioners of everything. And that's the truth. So there are expressed superlatives and words that express the very character and the demeanor of Yah. And he did not leave that to man to extrapolate what signifies him and what means him. So he wrote it in his language. He said, I am Kadosh. I am the Kodesh one. Don't let anyone give you the Holy Ghost. You see this Holy Ghost lie, they fall out like fools, don't they? Shaking like demons. Women dressed like slutty whores, effeminate faggot men,
talking like faggots and dressing like faggots. Shaking their buttocks with skin tight pants on. And the little boys are faggots. And the little girls are as whorish as they come. Slutty and wicked. That's a fact. I don't give a damn if you don't love me. As I said to the op that called from Pittsburgh, I'm going to preach in a moment. Last night, I said, either you're going to love me or you're just going to despise me. There's no middle ground with me. You like me or you don't like me. And I'm all right with that. Were there middle grounds with Yahshua HaMashiach? He despises a hypocrite. So you either love Yah or you hate him. There is no middle ground you're going to walk on to get into the kingdom. I would that thou would be hot or cold. But because you are wicked and lukewarm, he said, I'm going to puke you out of my mouth. So you're either going to love me or you're going to despise me. That's all right with me. I have no compunction with that, really. I have never lost one segment of sleep because one has despised me. I have never lost one ounce of sleep in the 35 years of marriage to this woman because there was a problem or situation that arose. Never in my life. He gives his beloved rest, and I'm a beloved of Yah. So I rest well, and I sleep well, and my body functions well, and I can work well. I can labor in the sun or the coldness of the chill, frigid air. It makes no difference at all. And when all that is finished, I can dance in the Ruach as what we call cool, twirl, and dance in the presence of Yah. Not this damn phony mess in these whorehouses. I will, man, not this folly. We dance because of the revelation of Yah's emat, his truth. It is one thing about this generation. It is not one that loves the zaher, the correction of Yah, the warning. That's what zaher is. It is Yah's warning. And Yah's warning comes through the shedding of light to be enlightened. To be strengthened. That's the warning. That's what warning is. That's what the word zaher, it means and implies. That the light of the excellence and the brilliancy of Yahshua HaMashiach shine through. When he comes, he's going to kill your damn dirty babies. He's going to kill your daddy. Well, Yahshua, quote, forgive me, y'all, they don't know Yahshua. Well, quote, Jesus Christ, the Lord, would never do that. The Lord Jesus would never hurt nobody. He loved. That's the prognosis of Yahshua HaMashiach. They don't know the mighty one of Yisrael. I'm going to preach here as the old ones would say, but I want to read this before I begin. How about that? Hallelujah. Hallelujah. I tell people the ignorance of their concept of whom HaMashiach is, it is pathic. It is pathic. Can I read this quickly? And I'm going to teach continuing from the beast and the power of that kingdom. I want to show you the strength, the attitude, the characteristic, and the power of the spirits that rule in that kingdom power. We have been duped, we have been duped, we have been taught to be ignorant of the ways of Yah. Because every Nabi, the Navi'im, the true prophets, they would always kill them. And a simple messenger as I am, no one accepts him. Because he doesn't fit the prototype. He's not outland with every whore and every slut. He has not congregated among some of the most vilest of activities and doing everything that is appalling unto Almighty Yah. And so because I don't fit that prototype, I don't shuck and jive with them. Never been like that. Never been a shucker and a jiver. Always been sincere. Always been upright in my ways, even though I was a wicked man.
Their damn Jesus can't kill a fly. He's a beast. But this is what the Torah in Giliana says, Revelation, says about the one that I know as Yeshua HaMashiach. As he speaks unto the assembly, as he speaks unto the assembly of Thyatira, Revelation chapter 2, verse 18. And in most writings or renditions, is that in red in your text? If you have what you call the KJV, it is written in red. So when it's written in red, is that Yeshua HaMashiach uttering those words? Everything in the book should be written in red. Because he is the Torah of Yah, he is the word. And the word, the Tabarim, the word, the living substance, the utterance, the power, the mind of Yah became flesh. He bara, he created that we beheld the image of his son. And it is that same word that brought forth his excellent in that body of clay. It is the same power, that word, that bring forth the excellent of his power in his Torah in Yisrael. You're not going to get it any other way. It cannot be tainted and polluted by traditions of the Baptist, the Pentecostal, the Seventh-day Adventist, the Apostolic. They're all dogs. The doctrines are doctrines of dogs. They're from hell. They have been inspired by the wicked one. It is not of Yah. When a man denounces his name, woe unto him. But this is Yahshua speaking, is it not so? In this, I've had this. This is the first book I preached out of. I've had this book for 30-some years. 33, 34 years. Aksimayon put a leather binding on it. This is the first one. So you see the red writing. Don't you see that? It is an OKJV. All right? How about that? You false Israelite thumpers, okay? Let me read what the book says concerning Yeshua. It says here in Revelation chapter 2, verse 18, and he speaks unto the Melech, the messenger that guards the message unto Thyatira. That is what the Melech is. He is one that guards. He is one that encamps about those that fear Yah. He said unto the Melech of the assembly of Thyatira, he said, I want you to inscribe to Hattab. I want this to be written in a sefer, in a book, in a scroll. He says, write these things, says, is this the Omer? Does it say, saith? Does it say, these other things, says? Is this what it says? The of Yah, the utterance, the speech, his mind, his word. So this one that is speaking, he is speaking by the power and the proclamation that has given authority unto him. This says the Son of Yah, the Son of Almighty Yahweh, the being, the child, the Ish, the Son of Yah, who hath eyes, or his eye in, his spiritual proclivity, his oozing, his eyes, are open unto the clarity of the direct, the way, the walk of Almighty Yahweh. So he speaks with great clarity here. There is no excuse. You cannot obfuscate what he says. You cannot go around this. This is so powerful, so high. You cannot get over it if you try. It is so low, it reached down to the depths of all our putrid, wicked, corrupt, vile, indignant ways. It scoops us up out of the pile of, I would say the one that start with the S, of dung. The one that start with S, you know what that, you know how to spell that one, don't you? I won't say that because when we defecate, we tend to get a little on us. All right. Whose eyes are like a flame of Ish, a fire, the eternal fire of Yah that consumes, and his feet are like fine brass. So you know it's not this damnable image that has been purported, this wicked lie that they call Jesus, unto Yisrael to distort their minds that they will not come back unto the Abba.
This is an image of hell that was created by a convoluted, vile, wicked mind. Jesus is a damnable, twisted lie created to destroy the very residue of what was written in the bosom of Israel. And that's why the people flock like damn fools. Oh, we got to praise the Lord Jesus on the first day of the week. And they deny the commands of Yah. Is it all right for you to do that? Does it take one abstaining from that, committing adultery, when we don't remember his name? And remember his Shabbat? He's going to reap this world to the gates of hell. He's going to tear it down. You can be religious all you want to. It doesn't mean a damn thing. You can sit here, listen to me, and go to your house of ill repute and whoredom. Woe unto you. Let me interject there. There's a beautiful sister. And Yabrak Yumachot Cosmic. She lives in Canada, Alberta, Canada. She sends tremendous offerings. She's from Jamaica. She's been there for 20 some years. And so she calls me and she tells me of the whole house she's attending. I said, come out of it.
Oh, Pastor Roberts, will you tell me there is nobody here?
I say, you just haven't found them. But there is someone there that loves Yah. So my hood, get the passport ready and come on down and visit. How about that? Hallelujah. So I don't compromise the ways of Yah for anyone. I am dogmatic when it comes to him. I have been dogmatic for the wicked one, for the lies, for this damn hippie Jesus. Damn him. Well, I'm saved and sanctified. You go ahead and be saved and sanctified. You don't even know what the word implies. They don't even know what the word implies. We have been duped and made dumb. My people were destroyed for the lack of da'at, for the lack of knowledge. Da'at, the ability to understand the wisdom of Yah. And when one has that knowledge, then they can discern. They don't have to. We've been taught in the whole house, I discern. Oh, let me see. Squinching your damn eyes. Nah, that's wickedness. It's wickedness, my ach. Man has the wisdom to see and say, that's wicked. That's not of Yah. This is your sure talking here. Let me read from the ruler and the master of Yisra'iyah. He has eyes like a flame of fire and his feet like fine brass. He says, I yada. He said, I know. He uses the word no. I yada. Yah says, I have experience. I know your mitzvah, your words. I know your words. We look at words and the English vernacular has distorted the very beauty of Yah. That's why we need the Ach and we as a nation to get back to the original language that we may understand the preciseness of what Yah speaks. Yah says, Ayada, I've experienced your mitzvah, your words. He said, I've experienced your hava, which is false. He said, and your service, you being an Ebed, a servant unto Yah, and your imuna. And I've experience your patience. And he said, and thy mitzvah, the last to be more than the first. The last is greater or meob. It has greater abundance. It's not the last of the works are going to be greater than the first. Did not Yahshua said, the works that I do, greater works shall you do. He said, you shall do works, you shall do the mitzvah with gadol, with great emphasis. You will not bow down to hell. You will not be ashamed of the way of Yah. You look at this damn wicked world, how that men give themselves over to that to ascertain what? Not a damn thing. A piece of tin, some metal, some stone. And it all fades away. They give their lives to think that they have acquired a knowledge, an institution of strength, and they don't have a damn thing. Ask the unemployed. Ask those with master's degrees and PhDs. You ask them. You ask those that were living in $250,000 homes. And see where they're living now. Give me a simple shock. I'm all right with that.
That's what the old folks would say. Let the works I do speak for me. Oh, let the works I do speak for me. Oh,
see, they didn't know what they were saying.
See, the word works, the mitzvah, the works of the mitzvah, the works of Torah. Let them witness of my beauty, my strength. We're dealing with a magnificent being that fight against Yah. But the beauty of that, he has equipped us with all things that is necessary for the battle. There is nothing like the sword, the harap, the sword of Yah. There is nothing like the shah, the breastplate that covers the heart, like the breastplate of Sadiq. And our feet shod, prepared by the truth of Yahshua, we are greater than warriors. Uriah will look at us and say, my boy, you'll sit. Come on and sit with me and sip some of this new iron, the wine that has flowed out of the veins of Yahshua HaMashiach. Come on, Yisrael. We have been dumbed down, so we are ignorantly dumb. He called his people sottish. We are dumb jackasses. Forgive me, Abba. An ass knows his master's crib. He knows where to go to get corn. Hallelujah. Don't intend to make friends that are my enemy. How about that? Listen, if I wanted this place packed, I know how to. I can't extrapolate what the world call intellectually. I can teach in a way that people will say, oh, you mesmerize me. I received the call the other evening. And there was this doctor that one contacted, the doctor, to talk to me in Nashville, Tennessee. And so as we began to engage in conversation, he said, I continue to tell the man, go to our website. Go there first, and then you talk to me. Because many, when I tell them that, when they go there and find out, I don't hear from them again. I talked with a man just recently from the land, what we call Yisrael. He was fluent in the Hebraic language. And I said to him, he even responded on one of the teachings I taught. Go back, experience the website, and of course, I don't hear from them anymore. Most men will be saddened because of that. But me, I'm not saddened. Give me a faithful few that love you. I can get the work done. He says in verse 20, Yah says, Yahshua said, now withstand, I want you to hear me now. I got a few things against you. Now, that is a proclamation there. He said, I got a few things against you. Against. If Yah be for us, when Yah is against you, all the world can subscribe to your ways. They can uplift you. It doesn't mean a damn thing, Yisrael. Yahshua says, I got some things against you. I got something in my heart that's against you. I got a few things against you because you suffer that Jezebel, Isabel, which calls herself a prophetess, you allow this Jezebel, this slut, to operate in the position of a more, as though she's operating in the gift of the Ruach of Yah, and then what she does is seduce my abbot, my avadim, my servants, those that are faithful and loyal to me. Do you hear that? They did not say that she has seduced my. Is that a possession there? Is that possessive? Is that possessive my? Yahshua said she has. And the powers that be has the power to seduce us. When we lose the love of the testimony, when we lose the encouragement of the testimony of Yahshua HaMashiach, when we're trying to appease everyone and talk in a way that we don't offend, and you allow them to defend your Abba, damn their Jesus, their gods. Damn their lords. Damn every one of them.
I don't retract that. And they brought down HaMashiach down to nothing. He came in his father's Hashim, in the name. Well, that means the authority. The name carries the authority. I'm from the Kennedy clan. You tell me that when those little young daughters of Barack Hussein Obama, our illustrious president, when they say, I am Sasha Obama, you tell me that the doors do not open? You tell me, she can go and they say, I am Rafael Yisrael. Who? Doesn't resonate with us. It has no quality of significance and importance. But you let Miss Sasha says, I am Sasha Obama. Do I have to say any more? No, ma'am. Clear that table. Give it to her. So don't give me that bull, all right? She can walk into any establishment and say that I am Ledbetter Smith. It doesn't mean a damn thing. You tell me the name Bill Gates doesn't personify fear and accolades of wealth? We are damn ignorant people what we are. We don't want to be called that because we think highly of ourselves. Tell me the truth, man. Show me how shallow I am. Show me how worthless I am. I'm not worth a damn thing, neither you. It's by the chassid, the mercies, his great kindness that he elected us. So don't tell me that the name doesn't carry any significance and power. That name, Sasha Obama, carries power. The name Barack Hussein Obama carries power. So he came in the Father's name. Yeshua says, you have seduced my servants. You have allured them through this coddling of their flesh and given them insecurity. There is no security in this nation. There's the kingdom power that's established their ruachim, or the spirits of darkness. And these spirits are so subtle, we don't know what they are. Because everyone wants to be wise and they don't know a damn thing. Everyone wants to teach when they ought to be taught. Everyone wants to be a leader and they have not learned how to be a servant. They have not learned how to submit and be guided by the messenger of strength that will produce the essence of the peri, the fruit of wisdom and knowledge and the strength of Almighty. Nobody wants that today. So they seek out those that are weaker than them or weak as them, and then they will say, we hook up. No, you come around me, you either are going to fall away, move yourself away. You're going to have to maturate. You're going to have to mature and become strong. And that's a fact. Can't go around. You can try going through your Jesus. It's not going to work. One of the questions last night, can I go to the house of Israel and teach in the name of Jesus and say I love Yah? Hell no. You go to a place that they reject his name. And it's amazing that these men will have Hebraic name. David Yisrael. Zachin Virmi Dabash. Yeah, we give ourselves those names. Ach. Yosipiah. Arach Eosalach. Zachin Yarabiah. Yisrael. That denotes the power. Hell. We are the dark, he was skinned. These damnable twisted names we've had all of our lives. We came from our slave oppressor to show our possession unto him. I want my name to show my possession that I'm his possession. That's what I want. Sure, our foreparents did well, but they did it in ignorance. And the last work shall be greater than the first work. So he shall raise up his messengers in this hour that they shall personify the ore, the light of Yah, in a greater magnificent way than our foreparents did. And they will shed light on their ignorance. And although they did it with a great studiousness and carefulness, they did not know any better. So we need men of strength and of warriors to stand up to protect Yisrael, to defend the very stake or the very death of Yeshua HaMashiach. That's what we need. And everything about us is tied to a corrupt system. Our names, our education, the way we walk, our dress, our attitude, to a damn corrupt system. And any time there's a change, we began to become resistant to that. Change has come over me. Come on. There should be a change over Israel. Not only do we change our walk, we change our talk, we change our attitude, we change our dress, we change us. It is by a constant hearing of the Torah of Yah. You must be reminded, you must hear it. And so we like these soft whorehouses. They call it soft pornography. You like to look at naked women, but you don't go to the extreme. It's wicked. Talk to me, Yisrael. Boom, got you. So you like stuff like that. These twisted, whorish looking sluts. Heads look like bumblebees and they look stupid. Skinny little coconut knees. And they make you women think you're ugly as hell. And you try to emulate a damn slut, you are silly as they come. They make you think you're ugly as hell. And you feel ugly. So you got to look like a $2 whore. That sell herself. Well, she can't be a whore. I remind us, I was in Colorado some years ago when I was working. And Hercules Morgan, I said, that's not your name. He was 300 pounds, about that tall. I said, man, he could not even walk up a flight of stairs. And so when I went to Colorado for 3 weeks, Hercules had been there 2 years. He was transferring a product back to Charlotte. And I knew Hercules Morgan. That was his name. I looked in the paper years ago. He had died. But anyway, he said, you know, it was amazing that although he was fat like that, women loved him. He could take advantage of them. So he goes into this place one day, and he says to this woman, I sure would love to have you. That's what he said. He said, will $50 work? She says, what do you think I am, a whore? He said, what if I give you $1 million? Would that change your mind? She said, that will. He said, now, can I tell you what I think of you? He said, I think you're a whore that can be bought between $50 and $1 million. I can have you with that kind of money. You understand? They may be $1 million whores, but they're still whores. They dilute the concept of the beauty of a woman, and these damn fruithead women think that that's beautiful. These little effeminate men look like faggots. I don't want to look like that. I don't want my hands to be soft. I want some calluses there. They're effeminate. They walk effeminate. And this is the trajectory of a bronze man? Don't buy me. Don't give me that. I won't buy it. I'd rather have a big gut. Huh? Hell, they take enough drugs, you can cut everything out. You think I would give my life to that? I'll just push the plate back. Look, listen to what Yahshua says. He said, you love this Jezebel in verse 20, to call herself a prophet, seduce my servants, and then to commit zana. Zana is this spiritual uncleanliness with every kind of religion. We have an amalgamation of what we call Christian from this Roman whore. From every kind of whore it is, we have that. That's what religion is. That's what Christendom is. It's an amalgamation of every kind of unclean practice that one can imagine. That's why you have Baptists. You have Methodists. You have Pentecostals. You have the Church of God. You have the Church of God in Christ. You have the White Church of God. You have the Black Church of God. You have Pentecostals. Yeah, that's what you have. You have segregation. You have the whites here, the blacks here, the Mexicans here, and the Koreans here. We're in one body. I don't separate this hand from this hand. When this old hand gets hurt, I say, ouch, and soothe it with this hand. You go to hell with that kind of concept and thinking. And you think that I will capitulate, you're wrong. You think I'm here to address things that give us a soothe, comforting. You're absolutely wrong. I'm not here for that. I'm here to counsel us, to give us the muzah, the counsel of correction, rebuke, instructions of the whole council of Yah. Yeah. That's what I'm here for. Yeah. Now you can pretend in your religious pontification all you want to, but you're going to hell. Yeah. And that's a fact. Yeah. It's amazing, these damn jackasses, they're bastards. They're mamsy, yeah? They're without the knowledge of the Abba. They have no strength of the Father, and they want to correct a messenger. Go to hell, boy. The other, nah, they're boys, little boys. Nah. A man's purity of his love for Yah will correct me. You don't have to say much to me. I've never been one that you had to converse much with. I watch you, and I see your perfection, your tomin, the way of Yah's truth in you. And I see your shalom. That we said you mark a perfect man. For the end of that man is shalom. He has peace. He has the eshah. He's happy. He's full of strength. And anytime you talk to him, you are empowered by his strength, his verbiage. We need men today. We got twisted femme faggots, butch bull dagger women rising up, rebelling against authority. You ain't my head, you lying Jezebel. Someone is your head. Yorkshire is the head of man. The man is the head of woman. Yah is the head of Yorkshire HaMashiach. And there is no man without the breath and the power of Yorkshire HaMashiach. He's a boy. He acts like a boy. He dresses like a boy. He talks like a boy. He plays like a damn boy. Man has a beauty that he doesn't have to masquerade. He has a strength that when he walks in a place, people wonder, who is that one? That's a fact. That's a fact. He's not hubris. He's not arrogant. He's a man. He personifies the beauty of his head. Yorkshire. There is nothing I can do without Yorkshire on my side. There is nothing I can do in the will of Yah without Yorkshire. There's nothing you're going to do. I frankly don't give a damn if you don't love me or care for what I preach. Because you're not loving me, it has not subverted me. It has not caused me to fail. Not at all. So I don't give a damn. Come on, Yisrael. I have a natural family. And as far as love, I'm a strange one. I'm a fruitcake, but that's all right. That's all right with me. I'm not offended. I'm not upset. That's all right with me. It's all right. I don't have to prove nothing. This is what proves me and reproves me. Let me read this quickly. I want to get ahead of here a little bit today. She calls herself a prophetess. She seduces and fornicates and calls them to eat things sacrifices unto idols. Unto good Lord. Idols. What is that? They sit down to a damn Easter dinner, to their damn Thanksgiving dinner, with their damn chitlins and pig feet. You might as well say, oh, amen. They put up a damn tree in their house and lights. What damn wickedness. And bow down to a damn freak that looks like a hippie, an effeminate thing. If I'm going to have an image of what we call a God, at least I want to have some kind of strength. I want to have, you know the word ish, the very first protocol of the word ish, which implies man. Can I tell you what it means? It defines masculinity. That's what it means. There's a masculinity there. He is masculine. And ish, he's masculine. And you see what the world is doing, taking away the masculinity from man today? It is taking away the masculinity. So will guys go to hell? So they're blurring the gender. No, man, I'm a man. And she's a woman. Don't call me that. I'm not a damn fool, and I'm not your fool. Hallelujah. There is nothing. Make it plain, preacher. You see how words blur things? How it distorts? Causing this religious whore out of this bosom of Catholicism It calls you to celebrate Christmas, calls you to celebrate Thanksgiving, calls you to celebrate Easter. You have your damn ham fried sandwiches at Easter, your pork belly at Christmas with all this filth. You give gifts and you sacrifice to a lie. You will not give your damn penny. Well, I went to my mom-in-law's house. I don't celebrate Christmas, but I did go and eat with them. I will not eat one damn dropping that you put before me. Not one thing. I don't give it a damn if it's a spread for a king. I will not touch, not even a piece of bread. I could be hungry as a beast. I will go and I will forge in the earth, in the grounds of the earth. I would never eat something that's offered to a damn idol, an image that is false, and you know it's not of Yah. Well, I'm just bringing you a plate. Go to hell. I will throw it down in your face and stomp on it. That's me. And I will not apologize. I will eat the meat, the body of Yeshua HaMashiach. He has meat, his body is meat, and his dam is blood indeed. Yeah. You eat something offered to a damn pagan lie, you know it can't be of Yah, because if it was, the world would not be so intrigued and so expressive about it. Go to hell.
That's all right, preacher. I like you. I wish I could sit down and hear you. Don't even like listening to you. I like listening to the brothers, the Ach, because they give me a little temperance. They do. Yeshua says, I gave her space to repent. He gave her space to make shub, to turn around, turn from your wicked ways, or teshuvah, to acknowledge your sins and say, I'm wicked, undone. I'm a worthless servant. He said, I gave her space to repent of her zana, her religious actions, that she embraced every kind of God and everything that defiles my name. And she repented not. Even when Yah warns us, when his zacher, when he warns us, Yisrael, we don't even repent. We don't even change our wicked ways. When he enlightens us, when he brings truth to us and knowledge, his enlightening is by his cautiousness. He cautions us. And out of that light come instructions. That is what his zacher is. That is what his warning. And we don't give a damn. He said, I gave her space, and she says to me, I will not do what you command. I will not obey you. I have a social life. You don't have a damn thing. I'm a part of the economic process, and I am progressively moving ahead. You're not moving anywhere. You're deep in debt. You don't have a damn thing. Die and see what happens to it. You came into this world naked, and Yah is not a liar. By the power of his immutability, he cannot lie. And you're leaving this earth without a damn thing. And the tears of your husband or your wife or your children will dry up soon. And their lives are not going to be hampered by you. I'd rather give my house the riches of Yah than to give them Rolls Royces and Cadillacs and anything. I'd rather give them the instructions of Yah and the truth of Yah, that my sons and my daughters will be balanced, that they will have the balance and the temperance of Yah. That they give them all the riches of the world. I'd rather give them that. I'd rather have a son that loves Yah and a daughter that loves Yah than to have sons that don't give a damn and daughters that don't even consider the ways of Yah. I'd rather go barren like my Israel has all these 35 years. Give me no children, Yah. Do you have a damn son to rise up against Yah and will not walk in the ways of Yah? Damn you, boy. Get out of my face. And a daughter that becomes a slut, a $2 whore, get away from me. You cannot embrace me. I didn't even embrace my natural mother. You cowards and weak ones. She was chewing tobacco one day, Ak. And she says to me, oh, give me a kiss. I said, I'm not going to do that. Oh, you want? I said, no, I'm not going to do that. Your mouth is filthy. I will not let her do that. Oh, baby, I'm your mother. My mother is she that hears the Shemach the Torah Yah and that operate, or she asa, she fashioned herself in the mitzvah, in the workings of his Torah. Who is my mother, Yahshua said? Who is my brother? Who is my sister? But those that simply hear the Torah, they Shemach. They hear with preciseness. They're glad when they hear. They obey when they hear. I didn't let the old woman hug me. I said, no, I'm not going to let you do that, old woman. Oh, baby, that's not honor. That is honor. I will not strengthen your deeds and your actions and have sport with your folly and make you think you're all right. You're not all right. I'm not going to do that. You can. I will not. If I walk alone, I walk alone. If nobody strengthens my hand, Yah will. I find too much assurance in the book. And so these are the circumstances that we're going to all meet death. You're going to die. We must be reminded of that. We're going to die. And in being reminded, you prepare yourself daily. Let the works I do speak for me. Oh, let the works I do speak for me. Oh, Yahweh, for I have sinned in my lifetime. Oh, but Yahshua, he called me in. So let the works I do for you, oh Yah, speak for me. You don't even know how to play the timbre when someone sings, because we're so pseudo. We have been shaped in a way. It has to be the way we have heard it. That's why I'd never do it the way that we've done it. Because it hasn't produced one damn thing in our lives. Hallelujah. That's a fact. Tell me the truth. You're not going to get by. You can hide all you want to, but you're not going to get by. Your age, your pigmentation of your skin, your wealth, nothing. You're going back to the earth. And I believe, or as in Hebrew would say, I batach, I know. What I know that I believe in, it is the truth. Let me move on here, because I want to point out something here. Hallelujah, hallelujah. He said, I know your service. He said, I gave you space. And then he says in verse 22, he said, behold, I will cast her into a bed. I will cast this whore into a coffin, and them that commit adultery or zana with her into great sarah, great tribulation, except they repent of their deeds. And this is Yahshua. He says in verse 23, is that in red in your book? He said, and I will kill her children. Is that Yahshua? Is that the Jesus Christ being taught in the whole house? He says, damn it, I'm going to kill them all, and damn your gods. He said, I'm going to kill your damn children. He's not talking about the being. He's talking about Taf. He's talking about the little ones. He said, I'm going to kill your damn children. I'm going to kill the ones that suck on the titty. Oh, I know what the religious whore would tell you. Well, that's not what he means. He uses the word. He says, I will muth. I will maveth. I will kill, I will shamath, I will eviscerate, I will destroy, I will bring them down to hell. He said, I will kill, and I will kill, and I will kill, and I will kill her children with death. That's all right. Who's on your side? You got to be on that side to be on your side. He said, I'm going to kill your babies. I'm going to destroy them. And he tells us the mechanics or the mythology he's going to use. He's going to use maveth, death. They're going to die prematurely. Oh, I know these whole houses with these big, fat, grubby men that play on the simplicity and the folly of the people. And got their whorish wives up there calling themselves the leader. He's the bishop and she's the pastor. Sit down, woman.
Had a woman to contact me the other day. She says, I'm pastor. I said, you know, I don't buy that. She said, oh, I know that, but I still want to come. You know I don't buy that. You don't come here talking that talk here now. Hallelujah. Does it say I will kill your children? Does y'all say that? Is this Yahshua or is this me? Is it written in red in your book? When it's written in red, just like it is here, is this Yahshua speaking in Matithiah right here?
Yeah.
Is that him? Is that Yahshua when it's written in red? So that's Yahshua written, saying that right there?
Yeah.
That's Yahshua. He says, I'm going to kill your taf, the ones that suck from your titty, the ones that suck from your shots. He said, I will kill your babies. Now, these money-grubbing dogs, they're not going to tell you this because they know you're simple and you're stupid. Yah says his people are sottish. He calls us stupid. They know you're stupid, and they play on you like a hustler plays a fool. Hallelujah. He said, I will kill our children with death, and all the assembly shall know that I am he, Yahshua, which searches the reins, the intent, the motive of the Levim, the hearts, and I will give unto every one of you according to your works, according to your mitzvah, according to your ways, how you walk. None of these mitzvah, you cannot take his name in vain. You must zachah ha-shabbat, Shema Chodesh. How can you say you love Yah? Any man says he loves Yah and keeps not his commandment, he's a damn liar. Now he can love the damn gods. He can love damn Jesus. He can love the damn Holy Ghost, but he doesn't love Yah.
Yeah.
No woman can say she loves Yah without keeping the commandments of Almighty Yah.
Yeah.
You're a damn liar. You don't have truth in you. You're not walking in the ways of Yah Yisrael. I want, above all things, for the messengers to be honest with me. Don't placate me. Don't play with me. Tell me the truth. Tell me the truth, man. Don't tell me a lie. Just tell me the truth. Show me my wicked ways. Show me where I'm wrong. And show me the ways that do not constitute the ways of Almighty Yah, that I may correct that. That he gives me space of time to repent, and that I may walk in the ways of Yah and do it deliberately with liberty. That's what I want. I want to walk in all things that please him. You cannot say you love Yah and keep not his commandments. You must keep the mitzvah. That is love. Herein is love. Here's what love consists of. That you shema, you guard. You hedge about, you keep the mitzvah, the commandments of Yah. That's love. You can express this convoluted emotional expression that has come out of this kind of twisted, abnormal mentality of being raised, because you only love those that were close to you. That's not love. That's folly. I love my sisters. I love my brothers. You hypocrite, you don't even love them. I love my sisters. Yah says, Yahshua says, because iniquity shall abound, or the ovon, the ovin of Yah. What is iniquity? Those that do not love the Torah of Yah. I know these liars will tell you that ovin or ovon, iniquity is that you go out here and smoke and drink. That's not so. If a man smokes, he's just a fool. But that's not a sin. He's a stupid jackass if he smokes, because it's going to kill him. It's a dumb practice. It's a practice of death. You're harming your body, but it's not sin. A sin is when one transgresses the Torah. That's what sin is, when you defy the mitzvah of Yah. And if any man coming to the knowledge of truth and sin willfully after he has come to the knowledge, then there is no offering for his sins. You're not going to get it right. Because they receive not the love of the truth, then Yah will send them strong delusions that they will believe the damn lie, Jesus, and the Holy Ghost lie, and the Israelite damn lie. They won't buy the truth. You buy the truth and sell it not. You gala. Why do you buy the truth? Because that is your redemption.
Yeah.
That's why no man is going to be able to buy or sell in this day. I'll get back to that, Yisrael. No man will be able to buy and sell unless he has the mark or the name of the beast. You're not going to be able to redeem yourself. But in that day, you have truth. You have the power. You have the gala of Yah. You have bought. You have truth in you. And even in the midst of all of the great agony of great Sarah trials and agony of one's mind and one's conscience, you can bow. You have a redeeming power. You're sure as your kinsman. Yeah. And so in order for those to have any kind of relief from this great oppression, they must bring offerings to hell. And so the enemy gets us in practice by celebrating the lies. Damn Christmas. Damn Hog Day, damn America. It's messed your sons and daughters up. It has messed your sons and daughters up. It has messed your sons and daughters up. America has polluted your daughters. Where mothers can't say a damn thing. Where sons rise up at their fathers. I was a damn fool. But I had a knocker. He was black as tar. And he said, boy, I will kill you. And believe me, I knew he would kill a man. And so that was enough fear. Above all, I felt sorry for my mother. I will not do that. I don't know why I said that, but that's all right. Hallelujah. Let me move a little further. I want to read something to us. Hallelujah. Is that all right? You that have joined us for this broadcast, my Achmikaya says to me, he said, you'll be all right. If you need rest, rest, because we need you in the morning to make sure that you present unto Yisrael those things that are vitally important unto the body. And we need to hear what is vitally important unto the body of Yisrael for this hour. Not all that say that they're Yisrael is Yisrael. You can church it up all you want to. I will not even attend anything that calls itself a church. Hallelujah. How can we have the love of Yah in us unless it is expressed this way in the book of 1 John? Hallelujah. 1 John, the writings or the letter, the Sefer, or the writing of Yochanan, of 1 John. It says this now, 1 John, verse 23, I want to read two verses quickly. And this is his commandment, his mitzvah. That's what a commandment. His savah. His savah, he has the authority and the power to instruct you to do it without any questioning of that. Can I show you an example of that? It's like Yosipiah saying to Lil Achabner, sit down, boy. And then he looks at his avad and say, daddy, I know you're the chief man in this house, but you got to tell me why I got to sit down. I know his quiet, unassuming mannerism. I know how he's going to respond. Just even look at his issue, she's saying. I know something is deranged in Asher if he says that. Giving us an example. See, he has the power, or he can command with absolute authority. Sit down. And he doesn't say, well, give me a reason why, daddy. Tell me why. I got my piece on my head. I'm dressed in my colorful outfit. You got to tell me. He doesn't respond to that. You understand? And this is his savah, that we should believe on the name of the authority, the person, of the name of his son, Yeshua HaMashiach, and that we should ahab, love one another as he gave us commandment. That's a commandment of Yah. Is not that a savah, a commandment, a mitzvah? We love Yah with all of our heart, soul, mind, and strength. How do we project that love? By keeping his commandment. Not because you walk around and say, I love everyone. I have never said that. I've never been a part of that trend telling people I love everybody. Oh, you want to love everybody. You liar, you damn hypocrite. You don't even love the one that's sitting beside you. You don't love the one that is in the same whorehouse you're in. And that he keeps, or he shama, he guards as with the heads of thorn. He honors, he preserves, he keeps his commandments.
And he that keeps Yah's commandments, these are his commandments. These are the mitzvah of Yah. These. And out of that we have the tributaries of the great Torah. The rites of Yisrael, 613 laws. We have all of that written. That it is impossible for us to contain, that we don't even know how to contain what we learned last week. So he has by his power intrusively written it in our bosom, our minds, and our hearts. So when we hear that truth, we don't turn away from it. We rejoice in it. It is the Ruach HaKodesh that bears witness. It is the presence of Yah that bears witness to the power that when the messenger speak, and then we rejoice in that Yisrael. And he that guards Yah's commandments dwell in him. If we don't guard the commandments of Yah, how can we say we're in him? You're not in him. You're not in him, Yisrael. Now, if you want to challenge me, come on and challenge me. I love challenges. We get in a nice hard day's work first, and then we will sit down in the book. How about that? You come here, work first. We feed you. And then after that, take a bath. You won't have much energy. How about that? And he that keeps, you that guard, you that preserve, you that guard the commandments of Yah, you dwell in the power of his testimony in Yeshua, and he in you. And hereby, this is how, you may have the Holy Ghost, but the Holy Ghost ain't worth a damn. Look what he says. And hereby, by this, listen, Yisrael, not this false practitioner, these ways that were so false, not those ways. When you went before people and say, you're saved now. Now just say, you want to, he's going to feed with the Holy Ghost in tongues. Come on, just lay your tongue back. What a damn demonic power. The Ruach was poured out. They spoke eloquently in the language of the Parthians, the Medes, Mesopotamia, and all that. They heard the wonderful word of Yah, not this damn gibbery lie. Shatata retiti mukasata mukatuka nikusaka ikayaka. It is the truth, man. You know that's from hell. Lay hands on her, she flopped down like a floppy tower. No fat belly preacher back there looking, see what he can see. It is the truth. How about that? That's bold, man. Damn their religion. I'm going to do all I can to tear it down. I'm not worrying about the Muslims, the Hindus. They don't bother me. There's a Muslim that works at Lowe's. His name is Ramim. And when he sees me, he gets excited because he listens when I talk. And so I went in the other day when Big Ramim sees me. He said, hey, man, my friend, David. I give him a little fist bump. You understand? And I don't hold back one thing. And he sits there and demands, and he's an educated man. And he just listens. He doesn't say anything. When I come in the store, he's happy to help me. Hey, my friend, how are you doing? He always tells me, you look so beautiful, so wonderful. That's what he told me. Hallelujah. I don't care if I got on blue jeans or blue silk suit. It makes no difference. How about that? Hallelujah. He's a big man, too. He's about 6'5". I got to look up at him. But I make him look down to hear what the Ruach speaks. Listen to this, Yisrael. And he that keeps Yah's commandments dwell in Yah. And Yah dwells in him. And this is hereby we know. we yada, that we live or we abide. We know that he abide in us by his ruach, which he gives unto us. He has given, he has nothan, he has bestowed that. So you don't even, you will know that you are in him and he in you by you keep the commandments. You guard the commandments of Yah. And if you don't guard the mitzvah of Yah, his ruach is not in you. And that's why this superficial thing we call the Holy Ghost, you can be a faggot and have the Holy Ghost. I've seen some of the most ardent faggots falling out like dogs. You can be a slut sleeping with every man in that dirty whorehouse, and they all got the horse. It is a fact. You don't have to buy it. You get mad, you ought to get mad at the oppression of the wicked. A Sadiq man, he is mad. He is mad at the oppression of the wicked, how they are oppressing the Sadiq of Yah. So that's why Yah says, as long as you're in captivity under this Shibuth, your mind cannot express the lawfulness of my Torah. You are in a position whereby you are shackled down. He said, you turn toward Yerushalayim, the city of Shalom, where I place my name. He said, I want you to pray not to the city, but toward the city. And I shall. It's a simple thing, isn't it? Just like he said, remember, isn't that simple? Isn't that simple? Zachar, remember Hashabat? That's simple, isn't it? See, it's the little simple things that destroys us because we don't adhere to that, Yisrael. So you cannot say you are of Yah. That's why Yahshua said, this slut teaches, and yet she doesn't teach them the truth. She teaches them lies, but it is not of me. I have not commanded her to do that. I have not given her the authority to do that. And yet she teaches lies and doctrines of deceit and seduce my people and cause them to deny my name, Yisrael. We can't go that way. We must shoot, we must turn around. We must turn around from our destructive way. We're destroying ourselves. We destroyed our wives and our children, our homes, you're destroying it. That's why the woman of the diaspora is so sad, because she has been maligned, she has been abused, she has. So she doesn't know how to intrigue, how to irritate even a man. And the man has been so maligned, he has been so rejected. He doesn't even know the beauty of a woman. He doesn't even know what Tifra is. You say, oh, main mama? All right, you're the oldest, so your witness bear greater than any one of us. You're old enough to be my mother. Your daughter's older than me, so I can't repudiate that or reject that. I would not resist that. I receive it. Your witness is true. And I receive that witness from you. You know Yah. The word know, can I express that? I know I'm redundant, but it's vitally important what I say. The word know in the Hebraic is yada. Not only is an understanding of knowing, experiencing, It is a verb that expresses a verbiage of accolades, that it is a praise. When one says, Ayada, I will never forget, as a young man, Evangelist Hartsfield taught me something vital. He says to me, we were talking, and I said, he said, do you know that individual? I said, yeah, I know him. I think it was at that time, it may have been, I don't know if it was Jimmy Carter that was the president. In any way, the conversation, it evolved around that. So he looks at me, he said, you don't know him. You may know of the man, you may know of the characteristics of the man, but you don't know the man. How have you experienced that man? And I will never forget that. So you have to be selective as to how you use words, son. You don't know him, you know of him. So he explained to me, he says, that's what he did. He explains to me, he says, do you know the president? He said, no, you know of him. You have never entertained him. You have never gone into his house. You have never eaten with him. And so how do you know him? And that has always been vivid in my mind. And so when I began to understand in my ignorance and my stupidity, to understand certain things of the language of the tongue of Abraham, Yitzchak, and Jacob, then I say this word, to know is yada. When you experience it, you shout, you rejoice, you get glad, like, whoa, hallelujah.
Can y'all lie?
Well, this is what he says then. 1 John chapter 2. I want to read verse 3. I don't want to read verse 1 and 2. It says in verse 3, in your chesed, the ketuv here says, verse 3, it says, and hereby. Do you understand that phrase? This is the standard bearer. This is the precise way. This is knowledge revealed. And hereby we do yada, we know that we have experienced Yah, we know him. Here is how, this is the roadmap. This is the derech, or the halach, or the way we walk, in the way of Yah, to know that we know him. Listen to this now, I want you to hear it. I'll get back to my preaching. The Nobi of Yah says, hereby. When you examine everything else, this is the only way. This is the only way. I don't care what religion says. I don't care what Re'ach Yisrael says. I don't care what Zachin Yarameyah Yisrael. I don't care what Bremin Dabash Zachin. I don't give a damn. It's what Yah is saying. He gives us the preciseness. He says, hereby, without any other alternatives, without any other way, masquerading. You can masquerade as a Christian. You can masquerade as a preacher, as an evangelist. It doesn't mean a damn thing. Hereby. That's why we know one another by the peri, or the fruit. How are the fruits produced? Hereby. We yada, that we know Yah. This is the only way you know that you know him. There is no two ways. Well, I know him because I feel him in me. Honey, you feel your lies in you. You feel your diddishness in your emotions. Well, I just feel him all in my bone. No, that's some of that corn whiskey you've been drinking, woman. Sit down. And hereby, this is the methodology. We know that we know him if we keep his commandments. You are a damn liar to say you know Yah, and you don't. You know Jesus. I don't have no problem with that. I don't even argue with men when they talk about that Jesus stuff. I don't mess with him. Okay, man. I see people, man, I tell you what, the Lord God Jesus has been good to me. I say, talk that talk, man. What are you talking about? Talk to me. I don't cast Yah's pearl before the swine, give that which is cow, the horse unto dogs. I just, because you're not going to convince them. I tell you, the Lord, I was doing this, and the Lord, I tell you what, boy, and the Lord God just did this, Jesus Christ. Well, baby, you can't tell me about the Lord Jesus Christ because I know the Lord Jesus. Ooh! That's what they do. Yah says, this is the methodology. I don't give a damn what they say. I don't care how. You may not look the part, but you must walk the part. You don't have to have the Cadillac and the fine, what they call a house. Damn the Cadillac. Damn the house. You don't even keep the one you got clean. Talk to me. People are so shallow that impressed them. Never impressed me. Never. Never. None of that. All I do in my house over there is sleep, and I eat, and I defecate bush. It's a joy keeping my little office clean. I spend 90% of my time there, my waking time. It's a joy. Got the suite. The desk get cluttered. Got to keep that straight. I kick my feet up on the desk. You got not crumbs, but dirt from. I kick it up there to get me a nap. 10, 15 minutes, I'm ready to roll. So what? Clothing. I like the way Mama sews. She takes care of me. All right. How about that? Okay. What is that? It has no value. That's not how someone knows that you're in the truth. Evangel Hartsfield said to me many years ago, 30-some years ago, Brother Roberts, if this materialism is the sign and the seal of our walking with Yah,
He said the faggots. That's how he said the faggots got Cadillacs and Mercedes-Benz. They got big houses. Of course, he would not use the kind of verbiage I use. He said, it doesn't mean a thing, son.
And from that point, I've never taught this love, this prosperity, because I know who the God is. It is God, as I read to us, you find him in Yeshaya. It is God and many. They're the God of fortune. Isn't that what the Christian preachers preach? God wants you to be rich.
You liar, you begging, you're taking everything they got.
You fat hog. Some of the biggest pigs in town. T.D. Jakes walking across like this. Come on. Chitlin eating pig. Fat back sucking. And people buy that from this pig. And he hobnobbed with the whores of Hollywood, this beast. Put me in that T.D. Jake. Let me run a revival there. You see what we're having out there? The little old sister heard, oh, we heard you were coming. We drove all the way from Louisiana just to be here. We don't bless you. I emptied that whole house out. That's all he done.
And so he used phraseology that impressed the minds of the simple. He walking like that. Hear me.
Can't even stand erect. Well, you denigrate people know I hate what these dogs have done to the women, especially the women of dark hue skin. Rape them and rob them, lay with them. You will never hear these men talk about adultery and sinful practices. Tell me when you hear T.D. Jakes talking like that. Because they're dogs. They're dogs. They're looking at your wife and your baby. These are freaks. And damn them. Damn T.D. Jakes. He shall burn in the eternal hell of Yah for his lies and his deception. This is how you know Yisra'yah. It's either this book is a lie. Hereby you know that you know Yah if you keep his mitzvah. He that says, I know Yah, and keeps not his commandment, is a liar. Does it say that? 1 John 2:4. You say you love Yah, and keep not his commandment, his mitzvah, you are a damn liar. Your loshon is full of shekah. What are his commandments? Well, these are the commandments of Yah. These 10. And out of this, we see the deduction of the Torah, the writings of how you deal with one another. So you can't say you love Yah. You're a child of Yah, you keep his commandment. You can't say. You don't even know love unless you keep the commandment. You love Yah with all. And because you love him, he gives you love, how to keep the next 6, all right? And because of that, you love Yisra'yah. That's why he said, love your neighbor, your re'ach, as yourself. Who were the neighbors of Yisra'yah? It was not the Hittites or the Jebusites. It was not those that of the Philistines. It was Yisra'yah. How can you love some stranger when you ever loved me? You are a damn liar. You love some man on the street that smell like defecation. Well, I love him. Take him home and let him bathe. I'd stay with you then, liar. Oh, I can't do that. I give him a dollar. What can he buy for a dollar? We got to get real. We need to hear the truth. We've heard lies. From the concept of Jesus Christ is the damn lie. We need to hear the truth of our Father. We need to know the truth. If any man says he knows Yah, he loves Yah, listen, you get all upset. All you want to, it makes no difference. He that says, I yada Yah, and keeps not his commandments, is a liar. Who's the father of all lies? Hashatan. He's the father of lies. So he's the father of the concept of Jesus. To delude us and to draw us away from the roots of our heritage, Yisra'yah. And we've all been beguiled. We've all been taken and hoodwinked. There's not a one out there that hasn't been. There's not a one out there. And so you have no supremacy over no one. Hear this now. He that says, I know him and keeps not his commandment is a liar, and the truth. What is the truth? What is the truth? What is the truth? What is the truth? We must know what the truth is. He did not say truth, but truth or imatha, the truth. H-A-M-E-E-M-E-T. Ha-imat, ha-imat, ha-imat. He said that he that says that he knows Yah, keeps not his commandment, is a liar and the truth is not in him. We must define truth, Yisrael. You can define it. I ask people that they say, well, his word is true. Well, what is his dabarim? His promises, that's his word, isn't it? The word taba means his promises, his utterance, his speech, his articulation. That's what it means. But we must know what the truth is. We must know what the truth is. And the only way you're going to define what Yahan wrote, he was a student of the Torah. We must define it by the Torah. You cannot define truth anyway. I don't give a damn what the Baptists say. The Baptist truth is different than the Methodist. The Methodist, Pentecostal. The Pentecostal is different than the Church of God in Christ. How could someone belong to something like that when these dirty dogs are sleeping with the women and taking advantage of them? Spend over $1 million a year defending these wicked men, call themselves preachers, from taking advantages of the women. That's wicked. I can see why Yah never allowed me to become a part of any of that kind of construct. Never. And even though I was ignorant, it was one thing that I can appreciate Evangel Hartsfield, although I haven't seen him in 25 years, is that he said, you're not going to be like the rest of them. And so he will rebuke me, reprove me. He did not let me talk like Joe McCoy. He did not let me talk like Kowser. He did not let me get up there and speak the way they spoke. If a man says he loves Yah and keep not his commandments, he's a damn liar. And if he's a liar, the father of all lies is Hashatan. And he says, because there is no truth in the man. Let's define that. Can I do that for us? We have those that out last night from Pittsburgh, he said, man, I found you, and oh, what a blessing. I found you, and oh, just, I'm so glad. And immediately did I rebuke him? He said, you're right. You're right, man. Open rebuke is better than secret love. The first scripture Evangel Hartsfield taught me, Brother Roberts, open rebuke is better than secret love. That's what David said, Yah, rebuke me openly. Let everyone see my shame, because I know you love me. What is truth? Can I show you what truth is? You can't let someone say truth is the word. I hear men say that. Well, it's this word, but what is this word? What is the dabari? What is the dabari? What is the daba of Yah? Can I show you the daba? So his truth has to be his daba, right? His dabarim. Okay, turn quickly. Hold that in John. And I want you to turn to Tehillim, Psalms 119. I will show you what truth is. Go back to your preacher, call the Seventh-day Adventists and ask them what is truth. This is what they tell you. Well, my friend, it's this word. Psalms 119. Can I read this to us? Will you accept it? There will be no adamants, but I can't just read in a thought. I'm a preacher. That's what I am. I am a re'ach. Tehillim 119, is there already Zachin? Okay, my Zachin says all right. Tehillim 119, 140. Can I ask us all the question, is the word of Yah very pure? Yes. Is the word of Yah, that he uses the word tahor. It is without any taint. No, nothing to taint it. It is without any type of nidah, any imperfection. His word is not just pure, but it's very pure. So his word is very pure, isn't it? The word of Yah is very pure. We all agree with that. He said, therefore, the servants of Yah, his abbot, those that abide in his truth, they love it. Do we love his truth? Don't answer me. Therefore, the servants of Yah love his truth, all right? His servants, they love it. David said, I am small. Come on, a man of your magnitude, he said, I'm small and despised, yet do I not forget your precepts, your instructions. I do not forget your hukkah, which is prescribed, your statutes. I don't forget that. Look what it says in verse 142. You see that? It says to Yadai, or your righteousness, your sadiqa, your characteristics. That's what the word righteousness is. The sadiqa, your righteousness, your character, your mind, your hamashiach. Your righteousness is an everlasting olam viad. It is without ceasing. Is the righteousness of Yah everlasting? Does he change at all? Is he the same today, yesterday, and forevermore? So his righteousness is an olam viat. It is an everlasting righteousness. And read those other words there. And what? Come on and talk to me. What? And your law is what? Does it say truth or the truth? It says the truth, right? Does it say the truth? Now hold that, because we're going to go back. Go back to 1 John. Hereby, he that says, I know Yah, and keeps not his commandments, 1 John 2 and 4, keeps not his commandments, is a liar. And what? Does it say, and the truth? Does it say, and the truth? Does it say, and the truth? And the truth is not in him. If his righteousness is everlasting, it's an everlasting righteousness, and his Torah is the truth, then we must walk in the truth, Israel. What is the truth? Let me show you the elements of that. You all might as well love me. You don't let me send an offering. How about that? Send a gift and help. Can I show you what truth is? Drop down to verse 145. He says, I cry with my kol lev, my whole heart, and Yah, you hurt me. He said, I will keep your hukkah, your statutes, what is prescribed, your limitations, your precepts. He said, I cried unto you, save me. I want you to do yashach me, yashach, and I shall keep your aids, your testimony, the aid of Yah, the testimonies of Yah. I will keep, I will guard your testimony. I prevented the dawning of the morning, and I cried, and I had tikvah in your Torah, in your word. My eyes prevented the night watch, that I might meditate in your word. Hear my voice according to your love kindness, O Yah. Make me alive according to your mishpat, your judgment. This is what keeps us alive, judgment. Nobody wants to be judged today. This is what keeps Yisrael alive, judgment. Bless Yahweh. That's why he corrects us in his judgment. Because if he corrects us in his ibra, his af, his anger, he brings us down to hell. He said, they draw night that follow after wickedness or mischief. They are far from your Torah. So when a man is far from the law of Yah, when he's far from the Torah, he is one that operates in mischief and folly and silliness and stupidity and clownness. He loves laughter, jocularity. He loves mischief. When a woman is silly, you can hear her from a damn mile away. She is a silly damn woman. The beautiful woman, she's quiet. That's the beauty of any woman, she's quiet. She's learned submissiveness. She's been taught by the Ema. She honored those that are old and wiser than her. She keeps her damn mouth shut. You all might as well love me. I don't have too many people love me. So why not love me? You love everybody, don't you? Ah, they love me. Hallelujah. Listen to what he says. He said, you are near, O Yah. And listen what he says. Psalms 119, 151. Does he say all or some? Does it say a few or kol? Does it say kol or for them? He said, all of your what? Commandments are what? Are truth. These are liars, Yisrael, the Jesus thumpers. They're taking you down to the dark gates of hell. You can't hear the truth of Yah and partnership with ones that are against Yah. All of his commandments of truth. Isn't it amazing that when one dies, they always read the 23rd Psalm? If that is applicable, why this is not applicable? If that is applicable, why not this? He said all of his commandments, all of these mitzvah, they are truth. not one. Which one we cannot do? All of them are truth. He said, concerning your aid, your testimony, I have known of old that you have founded them forever. So the testimony of Yahshua, it has been established from the beginning. And what Yah says, it is olam viat. It is forever, Yisrael. He told Yah to consider mine afflictions and deliver me, for I do not forget your Torah. You can't forget the Torah of Yah. Isn't that what the church has caused us to do? That was for those that were Jews. Well, what in the hell is a Jew? What in the hell is a Jew? Tell me what a Jew is. It's no descriptive in the Torah. What is a Jew? Well, I'm a Jew. Well, what in the hell is a Jew? What is a Jew? You don't even know if you're of the tribe of Yehuda. You don't know if you're of the tribe of Reuben, or Simeon, of Levi. You don't know what tribe you are of. We were scattered. I took seeds yesterday. I scattered mustards. I scattered the old mustard seeds. I scattered turnips. And I guarantee you, I can't see. I see well outside. Inside, I don't see as well. And I said, Yah, how do you find Yisrael in a scattered Iraq in this earth that has been tilled by wickedness? Wickedness is plowed deep in the... How do you find a nation? I couldn't find one seed. If I did, it would have been a GM. So it is with us. So how do you know what tribe you're of? How do you know you have God? How do you know you have Yosef or Nephtilah? You don't know that. We know that we are the house. There's only one house. Yeah. And you may be one of the Shebat, a little branch out from Yah, but you don't know what branch. You will know your Yisrael because you love his testimony. You love his truth. Yisrael. Can I move on quickly? He says this, that salvation, verse 155, salvation is not even close. It is far from the wicked. Who are the wicked? The Rasha. Who are the wicked? What is a wicked man? You don't even know wickedness, Yisrael, what Rasha is, unless you defy the Torah of Yah, the commandments, the mitzvah. Unless you defy the Torah. That's what Rasha is. You're a wicked man that defies the Torah. You don't love the Torah. And so Yeshua, the salvation, is far from that man. It's far from that woman. It's far from their home. It's far from you. It's not even near you. It says salvation is far from the wicked, for they seek not the hookah. They don't want to know what the statutes of Yah said. They lack a religious, nice, filling time. They lack the potluck dinners. They like to go and eat the damn pig feet, roasted ham. They like the Christmas dinners. They like the Christmas parties. They like the Easter parties. But that's wrong, Yisrael. That's wickedness. Once a man turned his back on the ways of Yah, he is subjugated to every kind of wicked thing. His house goes down to the way of hell. I don't care who the man is. When a man hears the truth, he cannot harden his heart as in the days of provocation and provoke Yah. He becomes double-minded, unstable in all of his ways, Yisrael. It is a sad commentary for us to coddle wickedness and to make one think that they are all right. I won't do it. When I die on the tombstone, if you were to put one there, you could just put he was real. Don't have to put no name. This man was real. Or they did that on the tombstones of the Israelites. That was a marker. That's how they could find the bones of Yosef and those that were buried on top. Come on. Just put he was real. He was not motivated by finances or anything, popularity. Come on, Yisrael. If I was motivated by that, who doesn't want the fellowship of Yisrael? I know I do. Come on. Those that are coming from Sukkoth, I've gone out of my way because I want them to enjoy themselves. They're flying in as far as Phoenix, Arizona, from Arkansas. I want to show them the best time that they could have. I want to cook for them. I want them to enjoy the place. I want them to enjoy it. Believe me. I want them to have a time that is granted. I want them to enjoy the food, the environment, the home. I want them to do that. There's not many that come to visit me. That's just it. And so when I meet a wayfaring man on this way, it intrigues my heart. And I go overboard for him or even her. There's an hold in New Jersey. She sends tremendous offerings. She doesn't say a thing. There's a sister that's in Iowa. She's been, for the many years, she's been sending offerings. I respond, say, my heart, let me know how you're doing. She never responds. But she sends the offerings. She sends them faithfully all the time. And her father is a holiness preacher in Mississippi. Isn't that something? Hallelujah. The great, great and thy tender mercies, O Yah, quicken me according to your judgment. Verse 57. Hallelujah. Let me stop there, okay? Let me move down quickly to verse 162. He says, I rejoice at your word as one that findeth great spoil. Do you rejoice at the Torah of Yah? What word is he talking about? His truth. He said, I rejoice at hearing of the Torah of Yah as though one has found the great riches. He said, I hate and abhor the lying, the shekah. I hate all lying. Yisrael, the one that wrote and asked the questions concerning the house of Israel, I call them Israel. I don't call them Yisrael. Concerning, can one teach in Jesus' name and say they love Yah? It cannot be. He's a liar. Because Jesus is a lie. It is a white concept from a convoluted white mind. Were you making it race? Hell no. The concept made it about race. And you are a damn liar to put it on me. You just don't have the guts or the balls to acknowledge it. That's what it was. It's a damn twisted concept of a damn convoluted mind. They said his feet, Yaakov said his feet was like polished brass. Anybody got a penny? Take it out and tell me what does polished brass look like. Now you can say what you want to. And we are ignorant people under the mentality of folly. We don't even know how to get from under it. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Jesus, Jesus, Jesus. Oh. Damn you, Jesus. Damn that wicked name. Yeshua is his name. There is no precious name more. Yeshua is his name. No other name like Yeshua. Oh, I call upon that name. Oh, Yeshua HaMashiach. Yeshua is his name, that sweet and precious name. There's Rapha in the name, only in the name of Yeshua. Oh, there's healing in that name, in Yeshua's name. How sweet is that name, the sweet name of Yeshua. Oh, how sweet is that name. The name of Yeshua, damn Jesus. It is the damn lie. That's what that we said. I hate the lying and the twisted loshon. I hate it. It's a lie. It's a concept from hell. You can talk to others with those damn lies, but you can't talk to me with it. Because I have the original KJV 1611 facsimile. You will not find the name Jesus in there. You will find Jesus. Jesus, I have it. So you talk that talk to someone else. Don't talk it to me. Don't come to me with your damn Jesus talk. And there are many that are going into the blackness of hell because they reject. Because I was brought up this way. So what? Just say you're wrong. I've taught in that name. So what? I've been wrong. You are sad shape when you can't say you're wrong. And you've been wrong. You are twisted in your damn mind when you can't say I'm wrong. I was wrong. I missed it. In my ignorance, that's why Yah says I winked. That's all right, boy. I got you in my eyes. That's the truth. And there are those fortunate like this man that has never had to wrestle with the Jesus talk, who's brought up properly and right. So he's not tainted. His mind is not corrupted with the damn Jesus talk. It's a lie. It's a corrupt, wicked, European lie. And nobody wants to buy that. They get scared when people get scared when I talk. When I say damn Jesus, they go, ooh, he may die. Boom! How about that? How about that? I'm still alive. Hallelujah. Tell me the truth, y'all. Don't hold back anything on me. Just bear with me. You all will be all right. You sit in front of a damn television all night. You clown and Josh, you can sit at some kind of family reunion where they're eating chitlins and everything, lobsters and shrimp. And you clowning. Well, I got my witness. You don't have no witness in the midst of all that damn filthiness and lies. You're part of it. That's why you're there. Hallelujah. Yeah. You all might as well love me. Say, help him, yeah. He needs help. Yeah. I know I need help. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That we said, I hate the abhorring lying tongue. The lying tongue is to be hated. That, but your law, your Torah, I love. He says, seven times a day do I praise thee because of your righteous judgment. Great shalom have they which love your law. See, you must love the Torah. That's why this world, Mr. Barack Hussein Obama, he's not going to bring shalom to the world. We see what's taking place there, what took place the other day in Misraim and in Benghazi, Libya. This is the mastering and the masterminding of the elitist wicked ones of darkness. It is Yah that says on the Hashatan, let it roll. America has no credentials in the world. It has no power, no authority. They are despised by the nations of the earth. They don't want you polluting their daughters and their sons and bringing them under these strong delusions of hell. Although they're there under delusion, they're in Benghazi, they're in Misraim. Here was this, they call it the fountain stream or the well stream. There is only one well spring of life. They call it the spring, the Arabic spring. Did not they call it that? There's only one true Arabic, only one spring, and that is the Hebraic spring. It is from the river of Niles unto Euphrates, whereby the name of Yahshua is going to spring up out of that land, and whereby we're going to sow and reap the abundance of Yah's riches, Yisrael. They call it the Arabic spring, did they not? And yet it has gone out in a damn fizzle, has it not? Because they don't give a damn about those little brown people, those people there. They want their riches, their resources, and bring them under bondage. And they crying for democracy. Hell, they're going to have democracy. Great bondage. No shalom. Give me the kingdom of Yah. Give me the Torah of Yah. Give me judgment. Judge me. And then only you're going to have great shalom. Yeah. Are they before the minds of the people? And rob them. And look at the nations. They're killing over there in Egypt. They're killing there in Benghazi, Libya. It has spread to Yemen and all over there in the Middle East. We want democracy. You don't even know what democracy is. This is not democracy, what we have here. We have a system of capitalism that rape your sons and your daughters. Take the beauty away from your damn daughters. Rob your sons of their masculinity that they are subservient to a damn dollar. You're intended for the prototype of his people. There will be great riches. There will be a blessing to every nation. And we're such damn fools we are. That's what we are. We don't want to get back to the old path. We don't even have the sensitivity of love. We don't even know what love is. It is the truth. You can say it under your breath. Say it loud, man. Say it so I can hear you. All right, then. It is the truth. It's not even an emotional, social attachment anymore. Hell in the 60s, I can imagine what it's like in the 50s. At least there was somewhat of a protocol there. We had it in the 60s. Yes, we did. This today is not even, it's not even polluted. Don't be hating on me, man. Hell, you don't even know what hating is. Oh, you don't be hating on me, man. You hating on Jazzy Z. Jazzy Z doesn't give a damn about you, your pimple-faced daughter, your fag son. He simply say, make me rich and buy my line of clothing, you jackass. LeBron James would even spit on your silly, stupid intellect. I'm dropping 274 pair of them LB, baby. He said, drop it. MJ will look at you and say, go to hell. He would not even give you the residue of his cigar. Can I get your autograph, MJ, baby? $12.50 today signing. I doubt if he even does that. Yeshua is his name. There's no other beautiful name or the name of Yeshua. It's a sweet name to me. He found me on the way, lost and deep in sin. Oh, I could not enter in because of my sin. And then the voice from Hashemayim cried, Yeshua will deliver you. Oh, I broke into pieces and said, save me, oh yeah. So I cry hallelujah to the name of Yeshua, oh, the sweetest name one could ever hear. Hallelujah to his name, the precious name of Yeshua. There is no other name like that name. Hallelujah. That's all right. I'm a fool for y'all. Back in my days, it was a song. It says, how did I go? Oh, I forgot. It was two of them about fools. One was, everybody plays a fool sometimes. There's no exception to the rule. Listen, baby. Who remember? Come on, you old heads. I saw mama back there. She moving the head up and down, north and south. You got to be lame not to remember that one. Talk to me. Yeah. Falling in love is such an easy thing to do. Come on. They didn't sing like jazz. These cats can't sing. I'm not a singer, but I'll do them. They can't sing. That's folly. She talking down on... Give me a little voice up here. Give me some right here. Huh? Give me a little bit right here. All right. Give me some. Shut up, boom, pa, shut up, cut up, boom, pa. You think that, set up, ta, ta, ta. Shut up, good focus, shut up, ta, 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 ta. They're not saying that. And people buy that. I mean, how do you buy that? That's crazy. Back in my days, at least when they were. Of clarity, some meaning. Let me close in a few. I didn't get a chance to go the way I wanted, but that's all right. I went Yah's way. That's all right with me. Oh, we're walking in the way. Oh, Yah, Harampa. We are walking in the way down to Tizayah. And we are walking in the way, the ways of Yah. Oh, we are. Oh, it may not seem right, but we're in the way. Yes, we are. Oh, yeah. It may not be right. We are the way. As I won't let nobody turn me around from this way. We're walking in the way of Yah in Yeshua. Yeshua, come on and go with me down to Zion, Israel. Come and go with me down to Zion, Israel. Come on and go with
Behold, come to death. We're going down to the bed of Yahweh. Come. It may not seem right, but it's right. Oh, it's true and right. There is no other way, no other way you can come. You must come by the way. Oh, the living stream of Yah, toss you in the way, the living stream, the stream of Yah. That's all right. I'm going to walk the way of Yah until he calls me home. Oh, I'm going to walk the way of Yah till he calls me home. I will walk in the light of the Torah. Yeah, I'm gonna walk the way of Yah till he call me home. Listen, come on, kiss Zion, let get ready, let you go. Come on, kiss Zion, get ready, get ready. Let you go, come on to Zion. Oh, get ready to go. We're going home, we're going home. That the sound of shofar, all right. Yom Teruah is coming. Put on your shout and shoot. Oh, Yom Teruah is coming. Put on your shout and shoot. We're going to dance before Yah. We're going to cool, twist and turn. Put on your shout and choose the design. Listen, I'm so glad he invited me to his mountain. I'm so glad Yah invited me to his mountain. Again, I'm so glad my name is on the invitation list. I'm so glad he invited me to his feast. That's all right.
Let me die. Either one, we're in the fields, y'all working, or die here. I don't want her down no bed, sick. Hallelujah. Let me die in the field, and let me die here. I mean that. Oh, I know I'm going to die. Getting ready to die, too. I want to close with this last verse here. Hallelujah. Isn't y'all tough? I'll get back. Akmikaya. That's all right, as long as it's truth, you love it. Hallelujah. Isn't Yah Tov Yisrael? Isn't it wonderful to know your name is written? You know, it's one thing about truth. It's difficult to, it's almost eating a certain way when it comes time to try to eat right. It's hard, isn't it? So it's hard to digest this. I hear from those that they say, Re'ach, I've just been tricked. I've been deceived. I say, that's all right. You've been deceived. The heart is deceitful above all things and desperately wicked. Who hasn't been deceived? I have. Come on, I deceive myself all the time. You can have no confidence in you. We have confidence in him. I have no confidence in me. Come on, Yisrael. But as I walk in him, you follow me as I follow him. My eyes are on the prize. There's only one prize, and that's the Melchut. The kingdom of Yah. I want to go in Yisrael. What else is it to aspire to do or to be? I was listening to one the other day, and they were talking about Shaquille O'Neal with all the millions he have. It's his doctorate degree. The person said, I feel sorry for Shaq because he can barely walk. Let me walk, Yah. Let me be able to go to the field and pick some beans in the morning. Get on this roof over here and get it done before the rain begins to fall. Man like that barely walking, arthritic knees can hurt. With all of his millions, they mean nothing. Mean nothing. He said it's sad because Shaq can barely walk. And so when you sit down and eat donuts all day, what do you expect? And
that's what they do. It's the truth.
He said, you can barely walk. And all those millions, they mean nothing. Give me some excellent knees where I can walk. I'm not arthritic. What will the money do? He can buy the finest of service. He will still not be able to walk. But a man like that has such constant battle with his weight. What is he going to do? He's young. He's a young man. Why is it that we cannot walk in truth? I want to close with this. This is, and next week, Yah's will, I will get into the depths. We're dealing with spiritual powers, princes, and what the Torah calls Zah, powers that have taken their command from Almighty Yah. Was not the heart of Paru, the great house Pharaoh, was not his heart in the hand of Yah? Did he not raise him up for the purpose to get honor? So Yah has given this dimension of darkness that even in Yahshua's time, they did not have to grapple and wrestle with. This is an intense time that we're in. We must. That's why my prayers constantly, Yah, raise up the messenger, the true men, that will not obfuscate their duties and will be sincere and genuine, will not hold back anything, even if it's losing his wife, his children, his home, his job, even to the losing of his own flesh. I will not compromise. I've never been a compromiser. And by the way, I did not get a chance to play my young friend a game of ball yesterday. He begged because someone has put it in his mind, but I will call the individual out one day that I'm somewhat timid and afraid of him to play. And so the word has returned to my ears, not by hearsay, is straight from my competitor's mouth, that I don't want to admit that I'm afraid to play him. And so there was a persistent from my young Ach yesterday, let's play, Papi. Come on. I want you. I was somewhat tired. I didn't want to go on the live broadcast last night. It was a tremendous task. But we had quite a few calls, so that was, time did go. So it has come to my attention, and I said to him, let's change the date. No, I want to play on the Shabbat evening on Friday. No other date. So I promise before all today, I will not allow anything to circumvent me from taking this young lad to the court. And I shall rain down fire with those three-pointers, and I'm still sharp. I still shoot it like a champion. He knows it. I drive with a menace, powerful move down low, and nobody's going to stop that. Not even your papa. I still got him down low. He knows it. And I'm not going to let the smaller version of him stop me. This Friday, we go for it all. Ach Simeon will be here. We're going to record it so there will be no excuses. Everyone will see. Hallelujah. So I want to inform you as well, an update. I had to renege on Friday because I was tired. I really was. I don't know why I was tired Friday, but I was tired. I got things done, though. Let me close with this. Yisra'el, when the Torah talks about a people that's evil or foolish or fools, when they are full of pride, it uses the words room, just like a room here. And so when a people become so hubris, but that's not what it says. It says what it says. We can understand going down the highway 55. Well, I thought it was 75. No, it said 55. When it comes to Yah, everyone wants to inject, interject, exchange, to delete. Shaul writes unto the house of Yisra'el there in Galusha. He says this. I want you to hear this. And I'll tell you where it is before I close. He calls them. He says, "Oh, foolish Galatians. You call no one a fool is." Have you ever heard that? Michel Ouz says in Galatians chapter 3, verse 1, he calls them fools. Did he call them fools? He calls them fools. He said, "Oh, foolish Galatians, who hath bewitched you through the power of the subliminal, through Hashatan, as Isabel seduced his servants to disavow the Torah? Who has bewitched you that you should not obey what? The truth." What religious whorehouse has bewitched you so you will not obey the truth? That you will not obey the truth, whose eyes Yeshua HaMashiach was evidently impelled before your eyes. He said, "This only what I learn of you." He said, "Did you receive the Ruach of Yah, the Spirit, by the works of the Torah, or by the hearing of Emunah?" You cannot understand the power and the dynamics of the Torah unless you hear, unless you understand the power of Yeshua. There is nothing that Yah has written that is undone. The all things must still be made. That's why we must come before him with the offering or the zabach, the sacrifice of Todah Yah. Yadayah, we thank him with all of our substance and we celebrate the greatness of Yah. He said, "Are you so foolish you are begun in the Ruach that now you made perfect by the flesh?" He was not discounting the Torah or giving them some reason to deny that. That is the truth. And without the Torah, we have no truth. Without that wisdom, we have no truth at all. We must walk in the mitzvah. This is what shapes our minds for the Torah. Is it proper for you to covet from your neighbor? Is it proper for you to bear false witness? Can you do that? You can't do that, can you? Can you commit adultery? Do you murder? Do you honor your ima and your avat? Your avat and your ima? You do that for your days shall be long on the land your Yah gives you. Nothing that brings death so quickly than a young man or a woman dishonoring their avat. I was a wicked lad, but I never dishonored my mother. I watched all of them talk back to this woman. I watched them say things to this old woman. I would not do that. I could not do it. I saw her troubles. I saw her struggles. I saw all she did to try to make room for us, to feed us. I saw her agony, her pain. I saw her tears, and they made me cry. And so they made me cry. I would get out on the streets and hustle. No money to be made back then, but I could go out and work after school and make $3. I could go to Puckett's Hardware. I could go to the store, Piedmont Supermarket. I could buy chicken. I could buy some pork chop. I could buy a can of biscuits. I could buy some rice. I could buy cabbage. I could buy food for the house when there was no food there. And I watched them talk to her in ways that were wrong. Dishonor her. I don't care how wicked she is, you don't dishonor her. You don't talk to her like she's not a human. When you said this, I would say to my mother when she would call my sister whores and tell her she's the B word or the female dog. I would say to her, "Can I ask you, mother, if she's all that, three babies by three different men, three different daddies, you had six of us by six different men, what does that make you?" She would be quiet. She would shut her mouth. "That's your daughter, you call her that. Look what you raised now. Look at a sad woman today. I haven't seen my nutritious in years, but she's sad. Sad. This is what you raise. This is what you produce. Come on, this is it. This is what your energy invested in, and you produce that woman." That's why your mothers train your sons and daughters in the way that they should go. And the Torah cannot lie. When they are old, they shall not go away. We're such damn hypocrites. They are hypocrites. They don't know what's right because you led a life that is suspect and false as hell. And they don't know what is right. You're going to stand before the judgment of Yah. Yes, it's true. Undoubtedly, he did not entrust me with children. I have none. Are you ashamed, man? No. He gave me a precious wife, 35 years plus. She's been kind.
She cares for me. She looks after me. She takes care of me. I'm all right with that. I'll go to the grave that way. I'll just ask for one thing, that let me be able to take care of her if something happens. And then you take her. And I don't mind if you take me the next hour. I don't. But let me take care of her so I can bathe her and wash her. Every man says, son is his strength, but she has been my strength. My charm, my beauty. I don't say that, but she is. Hallelujah. Just want to be able to take care of her. Be able to wash her buttocks if she can't. When her legs give out, I want to be able to take care of her. So I keep myself with vitality and strong so I can bear up if I have to. I do that for a reason. I keep myself vibrant and strong for that reason. So I can work. But if I have to wash her and bathe her, I will do it. I will do it and take care of her. That's one reason. Hallelujah. That's all right. Come on. I had one to call me the other night. One that lived, his son and his daughter. The boy is a damn faggot. And the daughter's a damn bulldogger. Who? I don't want that. You think I want that in my lineage? And I heard the boy talk to his daddy one day. I said, look, you faggot, you may talk to him that way, but you're not. Isn't that amazing? I talked to that little effeminate faggot. I said, you talk to him. And I said, you shouldn't let him talk to you like that, man. I said, you were not. And this boy was distant from me. But yet the voice on that telephone, he knew better. I said, you may talk to him, boy, but you're not going to talk to me like that. You may talk to him like that, but you're not going to talk to me like that. And that's your father. You don't know a damn thing. You don't know what circumstances arose between him and your mother. You take her side because you're weak and you're effeminate. You're not going to talk to me like that. You may talk to him. And as long as you're on the phone with me, you're not going to even talk to him like that. I wouldn't let you think he, his whole demeanor changed. He want to talk to him. Well, you know, you my son, I love you. No, tell him to go to hell. Damn you, boy. Faggot. You think I will let that dog come here? Go to hell. His little daughter is such a butch bulldagger, she's afraid of me. She's afraid. She's afraid of me. And I'm glad she is. Because I wouldn't let the butch bulldagger whore. I wouldn't even, I look at her, what do you call yourself? You're not even a beast, you freak. Well, they're God's children. You have not lied at all. They are God's children. They belong to the God of this world. Yes. He is the God of this world. Yes. Shaul said, if this message that this Bezorach has heard from you is because the God of this world has blinded your mind, lest the power of the truth shine to you, that you may be your shock. Yeah. I'm not going to deal with a faggot like that. And that's a fact. Yeah. I don't even know them. I don't know my children, my sister's children. I don't know my brothers. I don't know them. And I'm not upset because I don't know them. I'm not sad. I have my young sons. I have my ark. I have them here. I have them in other parts of the country, other parts of the world. Come on. I'm not ashamed because I don't have that. I don't feel slight or sad because y'all never birthed a child unto me. I'm not sad because of that. I'm not upset with him. Not one bit. When I see the hell that these wicked ones take their parents through and what they do to them, they don't give a damn because mom and daddy, you have not taught them a damn thing about love. You can't teach them love unless you keep the commandments of Yah. That is love. That is love. You may have a damn social attachment. It doesn't mean a damn thing. And I don't take one word back. My mother would say, I love my children. That's the problem. Put them out. I said to her, I will never come back to your house. Oh, baby, you know. I said, look, oh, woman. I said, before I ever come back here, I will sleep in a van. I will sleep outside. I will never darken your doors again to live here. And I've never, you understand? These are boys you have raised. They fall back on you like a crutch. I will never. And I met that when a man leaves his mother and his father's house, he cleaves unto a wife, they become one.
I will never put in a position like that. If I have to build me a brush up in the woods, we will sleep there. I will take care of her. If I have to ride on my back, if I have to go to the supermarket and get a pushing cart, and you lay in there sitting there, I'll push you. Don't be ashamed. And I will never put in a position not to be here. And that's why I want to live, Mama. He that will love life and see better days, let him refrain his lips from evil. And let there be no guile in him. So I search myself daily for that so I can be here for her. That's a fact. I don't talk like that, but I do. Greetings to you, all ye Israel that have joined us. Listen, we're coming to the Moed, to Ruach, on the Yom Shadi, Monday. We will gather here in the Beit. But I do want to offer these booklets that have been written by the Akas here. Beautiful booklets that will help you in your knowledge. One is called, Can We Keep the Pesach or the Passover Yah Outside of the Land of Yerushalayim? This was a rebuttal. It's about a 66 page book. It was the rebuttal, and all of my rebuttal is in red, whereby there's a group called themselves Israelite Heritage. They purport this lie that you cannot keep the feast days outside of Yerushalayim, and I debunk the lie. They won't respond to me. Obadiah and those fellows will not. You can write for this book. It will show you the validity of keeping the Moedim, the feast days of Yerushalayim. You must keep them. It's amazing. People keep Christmas and all the other lies, don't they? But yet they don't keep the feast days of Yah. And here's another one. Yah covenant feast days will bless you to understand. It gives you insight where you can study on the feast days of Yah, how important they are. And also this is one called The Importance of Yah's Feast Days. We will send them to you free. Just write us, email us, send us your address, our Ach Yabin. We'll get them out to you on next week as we come to the season. And always what we call the fall feast days, it is a time of renewing. That's why we must be conscious of the Chodesh, the new moon. Hallelujah. It's a time of renewal and revival, refreshing as we prepare. Something is wrong if we are the same old damn humdrum wicked ones we were yesterday or the day before that. Something is sick in our minds, Yisrael. We better grow up and mature. And so as we come to Yom Ruach, we're going to gather, we're going to sing. There will be those that have said, Reach, we will be with you all in service. We're going to join you. So you just follow the protocol here. There's nothing special you need to do. It is only the Moed of Yom Kippur. Now, we taught on that. You go back and listen to the message that was on Chet Ve'imat last week, of this week. And also, we have a teaching on how you determine the Moedim of Yah. It's an excellent teaching, Yisrael. I show you charts. I show you how we do that. And also, it's a teaching called the Feast Days of Yah, that these are my feast days. We have been planning that after service. Put that on again, Simeon. I want you to understand that the Moedim of Yah, they're vital. It's a time of revival and refreshing. And we want to do it in the utmost way for our little ones. I know it's just a few, but do it so that they will be excited about it. That's what it's all about, that they would carry this on. If Yah removes us, they will have the excitement. They will know the Shabbat. They will know when the new moon is. They will know when it's time. They know how to count. They should learn that. It was no such thing as children, a Torah day. They all came into the house together. When I was in the old Baptist whole house, you came and you sat down with Mama, and you all sat there, and the preacher preached, he taught. Now they got this convoluted pluto, that's what they play, and do every kind of damn twisted thing there is. You teach them, they learn by example, they watch their parents, they watch how they act and how they interact, Yisrael. That's the way that it should be. Yeah. Teach them that they can learn and they can see it. And they dance, and when they get up and sing with the choir, come on, let them see. That's right by me. They get up there and they move. Come on, you old ones, you don't even have much of the spontaneity, anything like that. But that's right. They get up there and they get to move in for Yah. Hallelujah, hallelujah. That's right. So I move for Yah. That's right, Mom. I'm going to move until I can't move no more. I'm going to move for Yah till I can't move no more. I'm going to move in the Ruach. I can't. Hallelujah. Yavra, come on. Arzachin Yarame Yavra. May the riches of Yah rest upon you all in Yahshua's mighty name. Greetings to you all. Yisrael. Yahshua's name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. All right. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
As Dawid was speaking, as I do many of times think when the ox speak, there are certain instructions, laws, commandments that you must abide by. Whether you're on the highway, if you're going to turn into the right lane, you're supposed to look first, turn your signal light on, and then you move over. You don't move over and not look, or you don't move over without turning on your signal light. But you see, many people don't do that. That's why there are accidents. That's why things happen. Because there are instructions that aren't followed. Same thing in a building. When you're putting a building together, you have to have nails. You must have screws or whatever is required to build the house or the building. And if it's not put together right, what's going to happen? It's going to fall. The least bit of wind is going to cause it to fall. That's why that Yah gives us instruction and his Torah and in his mitzvah. And if we don't walk according to his Torah and according to his mitzvah, we're going to fall Yisrael every time. Hallelujah. We're not going to find the high or the life in Almighty Yahweh walking contrary to his Torah. And we're not going to see the end of all things. Hallelujah. I want to see the end, Yisrael. Hallelujah. I want to make it in. I want to enter into the Melkut of Yahweh, and we're not going to do it unless we walk in his commandments and in his statutes. Hallelujah. Let us stand to our feet. Hallelujah. For this is a great day. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. A day in which Yahweh's mercy and his loving kindness has been renewed to Yisrael. Let us turn, let us shub unto Jerusalem. Abba Yahweh, we do barak you for all things, for your truth that has gone forth on this day. And Yahweh, just for giving us breath, for giving us life, and for giving us strength and more. Hallelujah, you have given us your mishpah, your Torah, Yahshua, HaMashiach. We do ask Yahweh, those that have came from near and from afar, that you will return them, Abba Yahweh, to the appointed place at the appointed time, and that your Melekim will be a camp around all Yisrael. Those that are listening by via of live stream, give them strength, Yahweh, and that which is needed day by day, Abba Yahweh, to keep them. We do barak you. We do give you Todah in the precious mighty name of Yahshua, HaMashiach, we do pray. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Hallelujah, Yahweh. Hallelujah. Yahweh barak you all, Yisrael. Hallelujah.